some mural present for the second interested party. It was that.
You are, you, both of you appeared in the morning?
Yes.
Okay, so that's all right. So what's the position this afternoon?
Well, we haven't seen our client.
Yes.
Your Lordship, we made an order, a firm order. Mikuna should be produced this afternoon.
Yes.
He also named the officers of the state. Who should be present in this courtroom. Mikuna is not here. None of the officers is present in the court. My lord, the law for contempt I'm told that it's possible they may be on the way, probably they could speak.
Mr. Biambo?
Yes, Your Lordship, with your kind permission. Yes, you made an order in the morning that Mr. Boynette and Mr. Matian together with Dr. Kielango appear before you. My instructions. Most respect is that all attempts have been made to reach them and inform them of the court order. But unfortunately, Your Lordship, they are not answering their phones and they are reliably informed that they are at the recruits training school where there was a pass out today. And therefore, as at the time of coming back to court this afternoon, we have not been able to reach the leadership.
When I gave the order in the morning, there was Mr. Mutinda, and I directed that the petitioner be here at 2:30. Who is holding the petitioner?
Well, Your Lordship, from what I understand is that the petitioner is at the holding facility, immigration holding facility at the airport, Your Lordship.
Yes.
And
under whose authority?
Your Lordship, I may not be in a position to really answer that question satisfactorily, and therefore beg that perhaps maybe we could have this matter mentioned tomorrow to allow the respondent an opportunity to appear in person to answer that question satisfactorily.
You see, Mr. Diem, what I'm concerned about, first and foremost, is the presence of the petitioner before this court. Before the petition appears before this court, no amount of hearing by any party will assist. So if I give an order, and that order was given yesterday by my sister yesterday, I see that actually you bring the petition here this afternoon. Airport is actually not very far away. In this age and era, it transmission of information to the person who is holding the petitioner cannot actually take that long. So either the court orders are not being transmitted to the person, or the person simply doesn't care. Police is a chain of command.
That's okay.
So if you cannot get the Inspector General, there's a third person. At least you could have told that release the petitioner to appear in court. The minister or the cabinet secretary now has somebody called cabinet something secretary.
Administrative secretary.
Yes. He's supposed to be assistant. And apart from that, you have the permanent secretary and the principal secretary. And the principal secretary has also some people below him.
My lord, another problem, if the Kenya was under attack, getting information to the Inspector General would be as difficult as it says in this time. I think it's not a concern.
Yes.
And unfortunately, when he came here, he must have come knowing what Mr. Matinda was required to do. And it doesn't have that image.
Please.
May I ask the court a little?
Yes.
My lord, what is at stake here is contempt on the part of the respondents against a court order. My lord, does your lordship know? Contempt law is an important component of fair trial under our constitution. And I would respectfully draw your lordship's attention to Article 25. States fundamental rights and freedoms that they may not be limited. And a fair trial happens to be one of them. A court administering contempt law is not doing so for personal ego at all. It is doing so to ensure that there is a fair trial, to ensure that the rule of law is maintained in our country. And that's why it is very important that our court must all along ensure that there is a fair trial. And anyone who is trying to subvert trial, the court has got this inherent power, or statutory power, to be contempt law. My lord, yesterday we appeared before your judge, and she made order. Those orders were defected. It will be set free in performed service of the order. The learned judge went a step further and said that Mr. McGrath should appear in court today so that she will proceed, or the court proceed, to make further orders. And I say with respect to those who are fair and reasonable orders from a superior court. This morning, when we appeared before you, Mr. Mutinda from Attorney General's office, whom I believe is a senior officer, legal officer, and another, the counsel, appeared for the Honorable Attorney General. And my lord, after some argument before you, the lordship deemed the papers and made an order. That the senior officers of the state, the three of them, the respondents, should appear before you. And above all, Nambuna should be in court. Again, may I say, my lord, those are fair, reasonable orders in search of fair and justice. My lord, you have been told that the senior officer of the state are attending a meeting or a committee. They are unable to be here. And we all know, those of us who live around here, that we have now a developed telephone system. You can easily get it done on the mobile telephone. You need to issue instructions or orders on a mobile telephone. But if I may say that you, for quite some time, I was one of the few Kenyans without a phone. But I discovered the drone that I can offer. I had to get one. So I now have a mobile. My lord, it's assumed that any Kenyan now has a mobile. And particularly the state, my lord, has got proper means of communication, quicker means of communication, to ensure that its policies, its business is not obstructed in any way at all. My lord, the gentleman appearing for the Attorney General has not told us who instructed him. What's most appalling, most amazing, it is very clear, it emerges very clear, that no effort whatsoever was made for that bureaucracy's order. That Meguna and Meduna should be brought to the court. No telephone call was made to the officer in charge. At Jomo Kenyatta International Airport to tell him that the court has made his order. Through our own intelligence, my lord, the count to that, that Meguna Meguna is held as a toilet at Terminal 2, Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. But it is so difficult to get in touch with him and to bring him forward. With the tremendous respect to this state, it is quite clear that a deliberate decision has been made somewhere not to comply with the orders of this court. My lord, some of us have been in this matter of Yukuna for too long. My learned friend, Senator Oyo, my learned friend, Honorable Kendra Amor, my learned friend, Julie Soweto, my learned friend, Ms. Rahadi, my learned friend, Mr. Kilifo Ombete. We have all appeared in this court before you. We have obtained orders. None of these orders have been applied to you. Yes, there are orders. None of these orders has been complied with. And my lord, Mr. Mikuna, would you quite right to look at me right in my eyes and say to me, Khamenua, since you came into this matter, what have you obtained for me? We have obtained nothing for him at all. All of orders that have been made have been out. Don't you remember, my friend, Senator Orengo was able to refer you to the jurisprudence of some of our other countries, including the common law country of the United States, where even the head of state was made to know that he is a lion under the law. He is a lion under the Constitution. Not very far away from us, our own sister country in South Africa, when late Mandela was summoned by the court, he went running and appeared in court and bowed because he appeared. Importance of obeying court orders. He appreciated the importance of making sure that the law is engaged. My lord, I can go on and say a lot of things. But before I sit down, I'd like to say this, your lordship, respectfully. My lord, your hands are tied. There's absolutely nothing that you can do. Your hands are tied by the law and by the Constitution. This one you can make very court to accommodate the counsel that you have this matter. You have to uphold the oath that you took when you appointed a judge of the High Court of Kenya. That means that justice, that power, and the courage. You have to proceed and issue appropriate orders involving sentencing those who have disobeyed the orders of this court. Obeying the court. The only way you can ensure that and the rule of the law. My lord, I will not be speaking the manner in which you speak. on which I'm speaking. If the state had made an attempt to play to you, the senior officers are dealing with some other of your matters. But here is the Commission Court. That would be a good negative fact. And you can that's not true. We invite that you put of making that you handle the when I did a little research, not Michael, from the book of Office of High Commission for Human Rights and the Cooperation of the International Partition, it's a book that I believe she is very familiar with. This is the United Nations in New York, which all member states are supposed to observe. It says the notion of institutional independence means the Chile has to be independent of the other branch of government, the executive and parliament. According to principle one of the best principles of the independence of the judiciary, the independence of the judiciary shall be guaranteed by the and enshrined in the constitution or the law of the country. It is the duty of all governmental and other institutions to respect and observe the independence of the judiciary. Furthermore, according to principle 7 of the best principles, it is the duty of each member to provide adequate resources to enable the judiciary to support performance functions and so on. In order to secure the judiciary from other two branches of government, it is necessary for this independence to be guaranteed preferably by the Constitution or failing this by other legal provisions. Your independence is guaranteed in 2010 Constitution. The United Nations jurisprudence makes it very reasonable doubt that orders of this court must be respected, must be complied with. Gracias.